Sand feels infinite. It is everywhere, on beaches, in deserts, under our feet. But here is the uncomfortable truth. The modern world is built on sand, and we are running out of it. Sand is not just something you walk on. It is one of the most used natural resources on Earth. Every city, every road, every bridge depends on it. Concrete is made from sand. Glass is made from sand. Even the silicon inside your phone and computer begins as sand. Yet not all sand is useful. Desert sand is too smooth. The grains are rounded by wind. They do not bind well in concrete. The sand we need comes from rivers, lakes, and oceans. Over the past decades, global construction has exploded. Cities are growing faster than ever. Megacities rise in years, not centuries. With this growth comes demand. Billions of tons of sand are extracted every year, more than any other solid resource on the planet. And unlike oil or metals, sand is rarely discussed. Removing sand changes landscapes. Rivers deepen and collapse. Coastlines retreat. Natural protection against storms disappears. Entire ecosystems suffer. Fish lose breeding grounds. Water systems become unstable. This damage often happens far from cities, out of sight, out of mind. In some regions, sand has become so valuable that illegal networks control it. So-called sand mafias operate in parts of Asia and Africa. They mine at night. They silence opposition, sometimes violently. All for a resource most people think is endless. Sand does regenerate, but very slowly. Rivers need thousands of years to replace what we remove in decades. Scientists warn that some regions are already past sustainable limits. Once coastlines erode and river systems collapse, recovery becomes extremely difficult. Here's a question worth thinking about. If the foundation of modern civilization depends on sand, what happens when that foundation starts to disappear? Sand built our cities. It shaped our skylines. It made the modern world possible. And yet, we treat it as disposable, infinite, replaceable. But the quiet truth is this. Some of the greatest crises do not arrive with explosions. They arrive grain by grain,